The design of Model S is really about proportion, and I believe personally that proportion sets the tone for the car, and it's probably one of the most important design elements. So having an electric powertrain underneath the car really set an awesome architecture. If you could imagine a skateboard, it's all on this flat floor. It's the flat floor batteries between the wheels, the rear motor between the axles, and the electronic module. Everything above it is opportunity. So with Model S, it's this just awesome clean sheet of functionality and available space to maximize the footprint.
I wanted to make a car that was that appealed to a broad demographic, appealed to men and women, had a lot of functionality, so it wasn't just a good looking car, but it was also a car where you could get
5 full-size adults in the main cabin.
And then there'll be the ability to have 2 rear-facing child seats. And these will be for obviously kids probably under age 10.
The front bonnet and the rear hatch is over 20 cubic feet of storage space, and that's more than any sedan on the market. That allows you to still have luggage in the front compartment and 7 people in the car.
The rear seats fold forward, so you can actually get a surfboard, a 50-inch TV, and a mountain bike in the cars at the same time.
Yeah, I think before I get to the interior, it's really important to understand the exterior language of the car, and it's. The car is really intended to be an uncompromised sedan. So we started with proportion, and then we got into the form language of the exterior, which is all about efficiency. Every aspect of the design of the car is looking for efficiency, even down to the door handles, which suck back into the car. The side vent is really a functional piece. You know, we've got a high pressure area over the front wheel. We need to exhaust air out of that. Aero-efficient mirrors, the proportion of the car with this fastback gives a nice slippery slipstream to the air. One of the most unbelievable aspects to Model S is the idea of a flat floor. And that really affords us a huge count in our drag coefficient. And then when we combine that with a real usable diffuser, we backfill the air coming out of the rear wheel housing back into the back of the car, and that helps the low pressure area behind the car.
The Model S is a long range pure electric car, so you can have a range of up to 300 miles with the Model S. Acceleration is very good, so it's a 5.6 second 0 to 60 in the standard version, and we're going to offer a sport version that's going to have a 0 to 60 of under 5 seconds. The handling is going to be really top-notch handling, and we're aspiring to have the best handling sedan on the road.
On the interiors is where we have a lot of innovation, and we start kind of with the centerpiece of the interior, which is the 17-inch touchscreen. It's really where all the interface components of the vehicle are housed. It's the iPhone of the auto industry right now, and it's this huge landscape that we can control and continue to update and continue to reskin and make the car feel fresh or personalize in that sense. And we can continue to upgrade and offer new firmware upgrades. We can offer new looks and feels for the interior of the vehicle. So you're never left feeling like you had last year's model. So we started around this big screen, and then from there, we just took all this available landscape that we had, and we're working on some really innovative storage solutions and functionality with a car that you can't even get in a minivan or an SUV. Anytime we do a prototype like this, it really is a lot of personality that goes into the vehicle in terms of color choices, material choices.
When the Model S comes out, that'll be my daily driver because I like to take my kids to school.
Not only does this car that's sitting behind me really convey kind of a lot of that personality, but it also really conveys the best colors for showing the form, the language, and for the efficiency and the lightness of the interior.
And in terms of color, probably black.
You probably see me rolling around in something that looks a lot like this.